pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce Judge Gibbons and our latest supervisor-elect, Stephen Russell, who is being sworn in tonight. Please back the floor.
All right, are you ready? Raise your right hand and see God. I, Stephen Russell.
I, Stephen Russell.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And that I will faithfully execute.
And that I will faithfully execute.
Duties and responsibilities of my office.
The duties and responsibilities of my office.
As supervisor of Scott Township.
As supervisor of Scott Township.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Please call forward Scott Weinshank. He's a newly elected auditor of Scott Township. He's sworn in as well.
Got to have a good numbers guy. All set?
I'm ready.
Hands out of your pockets. Got to worry, I mean, lawyers always have a hand, somebody else is coming.
He's an insurance agent.
I'm not going there. Can you raise your right hand? I, Scott Weinshank.
I, Scott Weinshank.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And that I will faithfully execute.
And that I will faithfully execute.
Duties and responsibilities of my office.
The duties and responsibilities of my office.
As Scott Township auditor.
As Scott Township auditor.
With fidelity. So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. Your first order of business as auditor, you've got to make sure all the numbers are correct, right?
Right.
Take away that clock.
We got issues.
You can do that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
With that, we have following commissioner board vacancies. Sewer Water Authority, 1 5-year term, Stanley Strahan is up. Zoning Hearing Board, Joseph Sullivan is up for that. And Planning Commission, Donnie Solansky is up. Do you have any public comment on the agenda? Yes, Rose.
Are you going to, because these are all blank, are you going to take comments right after you make the fill in the blank, or are you going to
yes.
do it now?
Yes.
Oh, okay. And the other question is these appointments for the water, for the sewer and the zoning and the planning commission. Did you interview several people or any people?
Two are returning, and the other two are both interviewed. Anyone else?
May I make a motion to appoint Supervisor Lodge as temporary chairman?
I'll second that motion. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. I'll make a motion to appoint Tom Wentz as temporary secretary treasurer.
I need a second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll second that motion.
Aye.
Aye. First order of business, I make a motion to accept the resignation of Stephen Russell as township auditor effective December 31st, 2015. It's a great pleasure, Steve, to serve as auditor for 4 years. We ran together 4 years ago. I wish you would feel like dogs sooner, but it was fun. It's glad to see you on board with us. Glad to second that more second. That Stephen has officially won the auditor. Tom, you had done the letters? I'll make a motion to appoint Tom Wicks as part-time secretary treasurer at rate of $19.67 per hour, 30 hours per week, plus meetings, township school holidays, 3 sick days, and reimbursement for insurance costs beyond Medicare, 10% copay. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor? I'll make a motion to appoint Carl Ferraro as assistant secretary treasurer. Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to nominate Stephen Russell for vice chairman of the board of supervisors, 2016. All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint KVA engineering as sewer enforcement officer at established rate, SEO alternates and rates Gary Wilder, $37 per hour plus expenses, Donald Carey, $37 an hour plus expenses, Oz Patton, $37 an hour plus expenses. Do I have a second? Second by supervisor Ollie. All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Carl Ferraro as township code administrator, code enforcement officer, and zoning officer at a rate of $19.67 per hour, approximately 40 hours per week. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Richard Pucci Esquire solicitor for 2016.
Excuse me, I have a question on that, on the solicitor. Are you going to be able to vote on that, being that he's your personal attorney?
He's not my personal attorney, also.
Well, he sued the township on your behalf just 7 or 8 months ago.
I have no problem with stating to the vote, Rose.
Pardon me?
I have no problem with stating to that vote.
Okay.
Steve, leave that for the law.
I'll make the motion to appoint Richard Pucci Esquire solicitor for the year 2016 at a rate of compensation of $1,200 per month, base and established rate of $125 an hour for additional legal services and litigation. Second.
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to reappoint KVA engineering as township engineer for current rate established rate. Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Make a motion to name Owensdale Bank and Cliggett as depositories for township funds. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Make a motion to appoint Ted Collins Jr. as vacancy board chairman. Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Make a motion to reaffirm road workers and set rates of road workers as follows. First class equipment operator, truck driver, mechanic, Robert Frazier at a rate of $20.58 per hour. Operator, truck driver, Gerard Frazier at a rate of $20.18 per hour. Operator, truck driver, Edward Labati at a suggested rate of $20.18 per hour. Truck driver, operator, second class at a rate of $17.81. Do I have a second?
Second.
Aye.
Aye.
I'll make a motion to reaffirm Stanley Strahan as part-time road foreman, $20 per week, at a discretion roadmaster, at a rate of 20 Jeff Kovach, Michael Burke, Greg Demming, Gerald Frazier, at a rate of $15.97 per hour. Part-time snowplow workers to provide access to CDL licensed township to be allowed for large trucks. One second.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Greg Talbot is part-time building and grounds and road crew at a rate of $15.97 per hour on an as-needed basis. One second. All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to reaffirm the following rates for preschool rates for 2016. Part-time preschool aide Pam Flarsky at a rate of $17.18 per hour. Part-time preschool aide Amy Lutz, $14.17 per hour. Substitute preschool aide Stephanie Bosaliga and Rachel Williams at a rate of $12.28 an hour. One second. I'll make a motion to appoint part-time building and grounds worker Harry Bauer at a rate of $13.95 per hour, and recycling workers Chuck Walsh, Michelle Ryman, and William White at a rate of $12 per hour. One second. All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set the payroll schedule for all departments from midnight Saturday to midnight Saturday. Money to be distributed every Wednesday by direct deposit. One second. All in favor? I'll make a motion to name all three supervisors and working supervisors to perform any such duties that may be required or confirmed by the road crew pertaining to overall maintenance of township roads, facilities with the approval of supervisor in charge of roads, roadmaster, and all the duties set by the board. One second. All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set secretary treasurer's bond at $300,000. One second.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set the assistant secretary treasurer's bond at $300,000. One second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, and the next one is, motion for sewer authority, five-year term on sewer authority. I'll make a motion to appoint Suzanne Krudiak to a full five-year term on sewer authority. We'll open that up to public comment.
What was the name again? I didn't hear.
Suzanne Krudiak.
Could you spell the last name for me, please?
Yes, Rose.
She's not done.
What's that?
No, I said, I'm sorry, I still can't hear you.
I said Suzanne Krudiak.
Thank you.
Yes, Rose.
Was that one of the people interviewed?
Yes.
And what are the qualifications?
She's a certified public accountant.
So what does that mean?
That means she's going to be able to straighten out the office.
But you're not in charge of the sewer authority?
We're in charge of making proper appointments to the sewer authority, Rose.
Okay, will this be a, Stephen, isn't this going to be a nepotism for you?
No.
No? Isn't that a relation?
No.
No?
Do I have any other public comment? Do I have a second? All in favor? Following is, actually, it's a reappointment, Joseph Sullivan, the five-year term, the zoning hearing board. We go back to public comment. Joseph Sullivan, just reappointing him, he served, I think, 10 years ago. No public comment? He can't comment. Third opening was for planning commission, and that would be a reappointment of Donnie Slansky. He serves, I believe, his third term, Carl? Third term. Hold that up to public comment. Donnie Slansky. No public comment. I'll make a motion to appoint Donnie Slansky to the four-year term of the planning commission. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Another one is for motion to appoint an auditor. I'll make make a motion to appoint Lou Parrish, township auditor, to fill an unexpired term of Steve Russell for 2 years. Open that up for public comment.
How many people did you interview for that position?
I didn't interview any girls.
Any?
I didn't interview anybody.
No?
Nope.
Oh, well, did you make the general public aware that the position is open?
Yes, it was.
Pardon me?
Yes, there was.
How was that done?
Steve made it aware, people who Steve wanted.
But no other way? No? And no other, just no interviews?
No, your superintendent, retired superintendent from Grant School District, Rose, he's more than qualified.
Yeah, I know who he is.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set 2016 meeting time and dates at 7:00 p.m. on the third Tuesday of each month, and the work session at 6:00 p.m. as needed. Change to be duly advertised as needed. Do I have a second?
I have a question on that. On the work sessions, are they going to be advertised?
Interrupting.
No, well, you said that we can ask questions.
On the appointments.
Well, yeah, but on that, I want to know, like, on the work sessions, is that going to be advertised? Or how are we going to know from month to month if you're going to have one or not have one?
Work sessions are scheduled for 6:00 p.m. prior to regular meeting.
Right, but only as needed?
Only as needed.
So you may not need it, so that's my question. How are we going to know?
Okay, go down the door.
That's the only way?
That's how we've been doing it for the last...
And how much notice are you going to give? 24 hours?
Yeah, we can do that.
Okay.
I'll just make a note, we'll give you 24 hours notice. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set the vacation schedule for full-time non-uniform employees working 40 hours per week, 5 days afterward to 6 months thereafter. One additional day will be added following January. For each full year work, maximum 15 days for new employees, 20 days for existing, or at the discretion of the board. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set the mileage rate for IRS allowance at 54 cents per mile. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Supervisor Labadie as supervisor in charge of recreation.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Supervisor Yoli as supervisor in charge of the police department. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Supervisor Labadie as roadmaster at a recommended rate of pay of $21.62 per hour.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Steve Russell, supervisor in charge of planning and zoning. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Mark Broder, planning consultant. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to set the holiday schedule for full-time non-uniform employees as follows. Half-day New Year's Eve, New Year's Eve Day, Good Friday, Memorial Day, 4th of July, Labor Day, Thanksgiving Day, Friday after Thanksgiving, half-day Christmas Eve, and Christmas Day. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to continue the employee health benefit policy for full-time township employees working 40 hours per week, 52 weeks per year, with an employee contribution of 10% of the premium cost of each employee. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to authorize all three supervisors, township administrators, to attend the Association of Township Supervisors Convention designated... Designated Supervisor Russell and Board of Delegate, and further make Township Solicitor and Township Manager eligible and at own expense. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint all three supervisors and representatives to Lackawanna Council of Governments, the Advocate Council of Governments. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to instruct the Secretary Treasurer to pay and receive all utility bills, insurance bills, and pre-approved expenditures. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. I'll make a motion to appoint Carl Ferrero, Scott Township Recycling Coordinator. All in favor?
Aye.
For a second, I'm sorry.
No.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll make a motion to appoint Vince Burns, Scott Township Representative, Lackawanna County Wage Tax Collection Authority. Do I have a second? I'll make a motion to appoint Mike Sicoli and Carl Ferrero, Scott Township Alternate Representative, Lackawanna County Wage Tax Collection Authority. Do I have a second? I'll make a motion to appoint Chief Gans as Open Records Officer for Police Department, Carl Ferrero as Open Records Officer for all their township records. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And additional motions. Stephanie Rock. We're gonna add two more motions. One would be to accept the resignation of Stephanie Rock, she's a part-time police officer, effective January 2nd, 2016. And to appoint, second motion would be to appoint John Lovick Jr. as a part-time patrolman for the terms of the collective bargaining agreement, pending the outcome of the background checks. Stephanie Rock served the department for over 4 years. She obtained a full-time job in Radnor, Pennsylvania. Bettering her career, she's full-time. She was a real good officer. Glad to see her better herself. Sad to see her go. We're short on part-timers. Chief Gans is interviewing part-timers currently. John Lovick interviewed him. He liked him. He spoke with Guy Salerno. I believe he's working for his department. We're short on part-timers right now, and I believe we'll be putting some more interviews done for, part-time. We wish Stephanie the best of luck. Is there any comments on those two motions? That, I'll make a motion to accept the resignation of Stephanie Rock, effective January 2nd, 2016. Do I have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. I'll appoint John Lovick Jr. as part-time patrolman for the terms of the collective bargaining agreement, pending the outcome of background checks. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Supervisor reports.
Nothing here for us. Just want to congratulate Stephen. Welcome to the board. I think you're going to be a good addition. Get together. Look forward to working with him.
Stephen?
Yes. Thank everybody for the opportunity to be here. I am truly looking forward to serving you over the next 6 years. And look forward to working with my co-supervisors and various employees of the township, various boards of the township, and hopefully get things moving forward.
Well, the United States, we did have pictures taken up at the pavilion this past Sunday, the Lions Club, and Commissioner O'Malley. They have donated $25,000 to playground, the pavilion. We did get a grant for another $25,000 for paving of the parking lot. The Lions Club just donated a check for another additional $5,000 for the handicap bathrooms that are installed at the pavilion. Looking forward to paving the parking lot there this spring, cleaning that up, and getting the salt shed built, getting that mess up there cleaned up. With that, I'll open up public comment on general items. Yes, Rose.
You made an appointment of Carl Ferrero for zoning officer, and under the, he was elected as constable, and under the Pennsylvania Code, appointment and powers of the zoning officer, section 10614, for the administration of a zoning ordinance, a zoning officer who shall not hold any elective office in the municipality. So, he can't be constable, he can't be zoning officer at the same time.
That opinion's been decided in court a long time ago.
Pardon me?
That opinion's been decided in court a long time ago.
You have a case line?
Our solicitor will handle that next meeting, will it?
Okay, well, as long as you have, you show me the case line.
Any more questions? Mr. Brinsell.
Well, you know, I really don't know you that well.
That's the thing, I like glasses, and I go hat on it.
I'm just here to bring up a situation that we have with sewer authority. Sewer authority's been fantastic, and he told me what the rules are, how the rules work. I would like you to take into consideration the circumstances that we're in Strawberry Lane, including our other neighbor who's up on top of the hill. They brought a sewer line up Stowski Road for the original structure of the sewer authority up there, where the sewer authority is, but they brought it to the tech park. For 6-7 years, it smelled real bad, really, really bad, couldn't play baseball. I just would like you to look into the ordinance that you do have, and take into consideration that people may have to blast to join the sewer authority, to jump into the sewer authority. They have to run lines that are going to cost thousands and thousands of dollars. 25 years I lived up there. Never once was they asked to hook into the sewer authority. It was next door to me. Now that they ran a pipe up through the baseball field, my property touches the property. Now they want me to hook into the sewer authority. I would like to see maybe about getting an amendment to the ordinance.
I really don't know if you need one, but our solicitor's here on Tuesday. He better answer that, because we have to call the site you, and he would have to confer with our solicitor first, because I'm not expressing my opinion one way or another as to...
I wanted to just bring up, so everyone's aware of what three owners... Go ahead, stand up.
The ordinance isn't fair to larger property owners. You know, I'm sure you know it says, if you own property that touches the road, you must connect. You know, if I was living right along the road,
say your name, please.
John Windup.
I don't believe you touched the line.
I have two sections of property that touches the line. But to get to that part of my property that touches the road where the line is, I'd have to go like 1,200 feet. I'd have to cut a ski slope up through the mountain, up through the South Sea Road to get machines in there. I've been quoted somewhere around $25,000. It's unfair to larger property owners. And we're asking if the supervisors look at the ordinance and provide for an appeals process, an exemption of any kind.
There hasn't been any exemptions granted.
I know that. I'm asking if they would look at the ordinance and revise it to provide for an appeals process for property owners like myself that have to pay an undue burden to hook into the sewer system. You know, 10 years ago when I built that house, this township gave me permission to put a septic system in there. And now I'm being told because, you know, my property touches, I got to connect. And that's okay, but the amount of money is not that happy. I can't afford it. And it's too burdensome on larger property owners. And we feel there should be an appeals process, an exemption granted.
I can't answer that question without our solicitor being here.
Where's the solicitor?
He was just appointed tonight.
Public meeting, he's supposed to be here.
He does have to be just appointed tonight. He will be here on third Tuesday of the month, which is what? Tuesday, Carl.
Well, we went down and talked to the sewer authority, and the sewer authority said, look, if you own property, you can't, period. We don't want to hear anything. That's what the ordinance said. We're asking that the ordinance be looked at and be amended so that larger property owners can have an appeals process. There's no appeals process. There's no distance. There should be a distance. You can't expect people to run 1,200 feet of line and spend $20,000 if they can't get that. We feel that there.
Okay, let's get to...
One other thing. We're just asking you to look into it.
Yeah.
You know, just take a look at it. We understand the sewer authority, this is it. You know, they're all by the book, this is what they want you to do, understandably. That's how they want it. But I don't think it was taken into consideration that these people that live, I don't touch the road, okay, at all. They went through the middle of the baseball field. For 6 years, I lived with the smell. I was just the guy that complained.
I was on the grass there.
They were there every Tuesday night emptying out the sewer. It's the point of, we're being punished, not by anyone here, just by the law. And we'd like it to be changed just for us a little bit. You know, we were here 25 years. And you're saying, nah, you gotta run it now. What cost is almost $10,000. And if I have to blast, my house is built on a ledge stuff. And if it happens, you know, it's gonna cost me a lot of money. If they have to put in, let's, you know, try to work something else out.
You know, if you're right down along the road.
If I was next to the road, I'd say, hey, I have to hook up.
But in our situation, we're so far away, it costs so much money, it's just not fair.
And I don't touch the road per se. The road's nowhere, you know where it is.
I know exactly.
I touch the property.
I'm not gonna make a comment.
I understand. Just so you understand where these three property owners... Our other property owner up there, and he's probably a lot further than anyone else here. And he just built his house and put his septic in.
Yes.
So, just take a look into it, of course.
Make sure you come to the meeting on the...
February 19th?
No, January.
The 19th?
Yes. Any other comments? Yes, Mrs. Hughes.
I just have a concern about the way the motion is made regarding the vacation days. The last part of that, where it states 20 days for existing employees or at the discretion of the board, that seems to be quite ambiguous. And the discretion of the board could really mean anything, depending on the feeling at the time. So although the motion was already made, I would ask at least that the board consider looking at this again, because it could lead to some problems with a decision being made at the time to one employee and then another current employee not getting the same amount of vacation days. So it could just lead to some potential problems. That's why I'm bringing that up, and if you would look at that again. And then the other question or comment is, would you be so kind to explain why when a new board takes effect that a new solicitor is put on board? Is there problems with the previous solicitor? And what would be the basic reason for that change? It happens, you know, with new supervisors coming in, you know, periodically. So
two members were not comfortable with prior representation.
I see. All right, thanks for that explanation. And also, is there any difference in the rate per hour between the former solicitor and what was just voted on? The person who was just voted on, is the rate the same?
What's that? Retainer is less. The hourly rate, I believe, is more.
Do you know exactly how much more that is?
I believe Joe Bryan was $95 an hour. Rick is $125 an hour. But his retainer is $100 less. In past experience, we get a lot of money from for that $1,200 from attorney fee.
Thank you.
Any other questions? With that, you're the motion adjourned. Thank you.
Welcome to the board.